In most roguelikes, the game doesn't tell you what lies in the next room, but Hades is different in that regard. It'll tell you what you'll be fighting for, so you're constantly deciding which one you'll go for next. Will you go for another key or for a boon from Zeus that will most likely give you lightning damage? But to decide that, you need to know which symbol means what. Welcome to Indie Game Guides, and today I present to you a complete guide on the gate mechanic in Hades. So we can basically split this guide in two parts. Now the rooms that give you items that you can use during your run or after your demise in the House of Hades. On the other side we have things that will improve your combat ability like boons and upgrades. And in the end we'll talk about some modifiers. Sounds good? Okay, let's get started with the items. Doors marked with a purple crystal-like symbol represent darkness. Now this is an artifact they use to power up Zagreus' abilities at the Mirror of Night. Katana keys are one of the several artifact currencies that allow Zagreus to unlock additional upgrade choices at the Mirror of Night or as well some additional infernal arms. Ambrosia is one of the several artifact currencies that are obtained via bounties. It is primarily used as a special gift for those who have deepened bonds with Zagreus. And as the relationship improves, it will give you gifts, but I don't want to spoil that for you, so just try it out. Gemstones are one of the several artifact currencies that can be found within the underworld. They can be used to commission upgrades at the House Contractor. Cairn's Obol is one of the several artifact currencies that can be used in Cairn's shop or at the Well of Cairn to purchase various items, and the Obol's amount resets to zero once you die. A bag with a golden mask signifies Cairn's shop next door. Now, Sharon's functions as the game's shopkeeper, selling Zagreus various power-ups, healing items and boons in return for the Obols he collects throughout his escape attempt. Now this naturally means that the next door doesn't have any mobs behind it. Doors marked with an exclamation symbol means that Sisyphus is beyond the next door. During these meetings, Sisyphus will offer Zagreus a choice between health, darkness or obols. You can find this room only once during each escape attempt and there will never be any enemies in the room. Now before we move over to the items that increase your combat ability, I just want to quickly mention that you can always hit me up on Twitter or join our Discord channel if you have additional questions. And if you want to have a vote on which indie game gets featured next, be sure to subscribe because we often organize open questions and do polls to decide which game gets a series of guides next. Now with that out of the way, let's continue to the next part of the video, the upgrades and boons that will improve your combat ability. The Centaur's Hearts are artifacts found within the underworld which increase Zagreus' current and maximum health by 25 health when obtained. The Palm of Power is an artifact that increases the life of one of your boons on acquisition. The Hammer symbol represents an attack upgrade boon from Daedalus. A Daedalus Hammer is an artifact that will improve your weapon by upgrading its attacks. And then we have the boons from the gods. Now there are 10 gods who will give you boons if you defeat all enemies in the room. So let's talk about all their symbols and what kind of improvement they'll offer. Aphrodite will give you boons that inflict weak and charmed on enemies, as well as improve some survivability. Ares will give you boons that inflict doom, create blade rifts, and increase the damage of your attacks. Artemis will give you boons that grant critical hits and improve cast abilities. Athena gives you boons that allow abilities to deflect projectiles and improve various defensive options. Demeter's boons mostly revolve around Shill, which is a stackable debuff that'll slow down your enemies. Dionysus' boons are mostly based on Hangover, which deals continuous damage to afflicted enemies every half second. And a Hangover can be stacked onto an enemy up to a base amount of 5 times and stacks wear off one at a time after 4 seconds. Many of Poseidon's boons apply knockback to your abilities. Now knockback causes an ability to push an enemy an additional distance away from Zagreus in the direction they were attacked from. These boons also include a status curse called Rupture, which deals damage to enemies when they move. Zeus's boons mostly revolve around chain lightning and lightning ball effects and they inflict jolted. Boons from Hermes function quite different from the other Olympians. None of his boons occupy one of the 5 main slots, such as they are designed to be mixed with and support other gods' boons. Also, none of Hermes' boons can be upgraded with a Palm of Power. For our 10th god, things are a little bit different. Now, sometimes in rooms you may find a hole in the floor and for a small sacrifice of health you may meet our 10th god. Now the Chaos boons function differently from the Olympian gods boons because they come in 2 halves, a curse and a blessing, which are randomly selected. Now the curse negatively affects Zagreus for a given number of encounters, at which point it permanently transforms into a blessing for the remainder of the run. The rarity of the overall boons only affect the blessing. Now a boon's name depends on which effects were randomly chosen, with the first half being the curse and the second half being the blessing. You can only find the gate to this god randomly in rooms, and unlike other boons, you can get the same blessing more than once in a run, and the effects actually stack. Now, their boons cannot be upgraded with a Palm of Power, by the way. Okay, so let's talk about some exceptions. Now, in case you encounter a glittering darkness symbol with a skull, that means there is a boss fight ahead. Other than darkness, there can also be other symbols like glittering titan blood, diamond, and ambrosia, which means boss encounters as well. On some doors you will see some glittering symbols accompanied with a small skull. This means that the next door will have some higher difficulty level mobs like armored mobs, mini bosses, or bosses themselves. However, this will also mean that the rewards from these rooms will be doubled. And if you find a door with two symbols of a different god, that means that you can enter the room, choose a boon, and the other god will throw a number of enemies at you and either buff them or spawn AoE attacks. And if you defeat them all, you may take the second boon as well. And that sums about everything up you need to know to navigate through the underworld in Hades. Now you'll know what you'll really be putting your life on the line for before you head through the door. And if you liked the video, be sure to give the video a thumbs up so other people can find it too. And if you want to see more guides like this one for your favorite indie games, consider subscribing because we're putting out 3 guides every week just like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya!